Terminologies used in the interpretation of CBC Analyzer reports.
First, let us discuss some terms used in ISO with regard to ranges. Analytical Measurement Range, that is AMR. The AMR is the range of analyte values that a method can directly measure on the specimen without any dilution or pre-treatment. This range is also called the linearity and is specified by the manufacturer but needs to be verified by the lab. This range is fed in the machine by the manufacturer. Every equipment has an analytical measurement range, which is the linearity limit for the analyte with possible errors at varying levels. The upper and the lower limits will be specific. Below and above the defined limits, the equipment will flag the result. In this case, an exclamation mark. It means that the result has exceeded the linearity limit and the sample should be diluted for upper ranges exceeding the AMR. The result is then calculated by multiplying the result with the dilution factor. All labs should have clear instructions in their SOPs regarding dilutions for each analyte. If the value is less than the AMR, the report should be less than the AMR. Example, less than 10 in platelet count. Clinical reportable range, that is CRR. The CRR is the range of analyte values that a method can report as a quantitative result, allowing for specimen dilution, concentration, or other pretreatment used to extend the AMR. The lab must specify the maximum concentration or dilution that may be performed to obtain a reportable result.
Also called reportable range and should be specified in the SOP ISO 15189 5.5.3.
For AMR and CRR calculations, please refer to L4L QC module and tool. In this sample, the value of hemoglobin is 25 grams per deciliter. The AMR is 25, which is the upper limit of linearity, but you may not need dilution as 25 is a limit seldom exceeded by hemoglobin. However, in case of WBCs, AMR is 99,000, that is less than 1 lakh. In cases of leukemias, especially CML, where WBC count can go very high, a dilution may be needed depending on the laboratory's defined CRR. If the lab has set 10 lakhs as the CRR, a dilution up to 1:9 should be done. Dilutions should be started at 1:1, and if it is still flagged, further dilution should be done. The value obtained by running the diluted sample should be multiplied by the appropriate dilution factor, BRI, Biological Reference Interval. It is a range of value expected for a designated population where 95% of the individuals are presumed to be healthy. This is also called normal range to decide whether a result of a certain examination is positive or negative to make clinical decision. It should be determined and fed in the machine by the user. The BRI varies with age and the gender. It is important to include these values into your LIS as per age and gender to provide a meaningful report. Alternatively, these can be printed on the lab stationery.
In the newborn age group, the BRI, that is biological reference interval, exceeds the linearity of the equipment.
Every lab should understand these factors to help in the decision making. Please go through the chart shown on the screen for the normal ranges from the reference book of hematology, Dacey and Lewis. Procedure for feeding the ranges in the machine. The equipment will generally accept only one range. So, outliers with regard to age and gender can be understood only if the values are defined in the LIS. Critical alert values. Critical alert values are the results which require rapid attention of the clinician to avert a medical emergency. These values are defined by lab based on clinician and or patient need. Example, a hemoglobin value of less than 4 gram per deciliter or a platelet count of less than 30,000 per ml should be reported immediately either to the treating clinician or the patient as per the laboratory policy. Teat's textbook of biochemistry has a good database on critical alerts. Flags. Examples of some common flags are: exclamatory indicates data out of linearity. Plus indicates data exceeds upper mark limits of BRI. Minus indicates data below lower mark limits of BRI. Asterisk indicates data low on reliability. Few examples. When sample values fall outside the BRI limits fed in the machine, flagging is seen on the result. 1. Plus flag before the RBC count indicating erythrocytosis or increased RBC count. Minus flag before MCV indicating microcytosis, and minus flag before MCH meaning hyperchromia. 2. T2 before mixed and neutrophil count in differential counts indicating inability to differentiate between neutrophils and mixed cell population at T2 level. This indicates unreliability of the data. The differential count needs to be done manually in such cases. Go through the flag list provided by the manufacturer and find the cause. Let us also discuss a few more terminologies and interpretations in CBC indices. Mensur index. This is the ratio of MCV to the RBC count. It is useful in differentiating iron deficiency anemia from thalassemia. Mensur index is equal to MCV divided by RBC count. Less than 13, beta thalassemia trait. Greater than 14, iron deficiency anemia. HNH correlation. If RBC count and hemoglobin levels are both normal, the hematocrit or the PCV is approximately 3 times the hemoglobin level. A hemoglobin of approximately 10 m by dl will have a HCT of 30 plus or minus 3, that is 27 to 33. MCHC greater than 36 maybe is indicative of cold agglutination. Such samples should be incubated at 37 degrees centigrade and rerun. Persistent high MCHC may be indicative of a spirocytic process.